They use too hard. That's the bottom line. Have a great day, everybody. Here's Stuart Varney and Varney and Company. Stu.
Yeah, in reality, I didn't hear that, so I'm not going to respond, okay?
Oh, you missed a good one.
I know I did. All right. The president invites all Republican senators for lunch at the White House today. What will he say to them? What would you say to them? Good morning, everyone. After the GOP's epic healthcare fail, President Trump meets the senators who could not keep an election promise. Obamacare is still the law of the land, thanks to the Republicans. Will he give them a dressing down? His base would love that. I think he should pivot immediately to tax cuts. That remains the most important part of his growth program, and it's another area where Republicans are divided. At stake, the Trump presidency and the electoral future of the Republican Party. If there is now a tax cut fail, say goodbye to 3% growth and say hello to Speaker Nancy Pelosi. There's a lot at stake for investors, too. The Trump rally is based at least in part on the expectation of Trump tax cuts and Trump's growth agenda. What happens to the rally if the Republicans fail again? This is crunch time. Only the Democrats will be happy if there's another Republican fail. Varney and Company is about to begin. All right, now futures are pointing towards a very slight gain for the Dow, but I have to warn you, IBM will be a big drag on the Dow Industrial Average. There's a long-term negative trend there, IBM taking in less and less money as the years go by. And that Watson, you've seen the ads? Not a wild success. More on that in just a moment. Now look at Amazon and Blue Apron. From rumor to reality in a matter of days. We heard rumors a few days ago. Now Amazon is advertising its rival meal prep service. No recovery for Blue Apron shares. Am I right in my premise that they've gone from speculation to reality very quickly?
Yeah, I mean, you know, Blue Apron and others, by the way, in this particular segment of the food industry are going, oh, great. listen, the Amazon slogan is, we do the prep, you be the chef. And those kits are already up and running on the website, although yesterday they had one on there offering a steak dinner with Parmesan fries and snap ease. It was unavailable whether it was sold out or not, but already, if you belong to the $14.99 per month grocery delivery service, these products are up and running.
Lizzie?
You know, if Amazon even files a patent application, it can knock a company
out.
Right.
Yes.
Market.
And it went from, literally, it was rumor last Friday, was it?
Which killed Blue Apron.
Killed Blue Apron.
Yeah.
Now it's Wednesday.
And here we are.
And they're advertising the product.
Yeah.
It's on.
Wow.
God, Lord.
It's a steamroller.
Now, here, let's get back to IBM. Less and less money coming in there. We're going to call them old tech versus the new tech of the Fabulous Five. That stock is down close to 3%. That's pre-market. Now, I want to know about Watson. I've seen all the ads. Yeah. Success or failure, Liz?
It's the heart and soul of IBM. Jeffries is saying it's a failure. Too costly, too expensive, too confusing, the Watson platform. You have to hire consultants to figure it out. That's according to Jeffries. And IBM is not hiring, according to Jeffries, at the same rate that Amazon and Apple are for their artificial intelligence engineers. Ginni Rometty overseeing 5.5 years worth of steady sales drops. And according to them, Jeffries, she has not overseen a single quarter of sales growth. So profits and revenues down year over year. It may shave 28 points off the Dow at the open.
Yeah, because IBM's a Dow stock. All right, thanks, Liz. Let's get back to politics. President Trump has invited all Republican senators for lunch at the White House today. Healthcare is going to come up. Here's President Trump. He says, let Obamacare fail. Roll it.
Let Obamacare fail. We're not going to own it. I'm not going to own it. I can tell you the Republicans are not going to own it. We'll let Obamacare fail, and then the Democrats are going to come to us and they're going to say, how do we fix it? How do we fix it? Or how do we come up with a new plan?
The Republicans are not going to own it? We'll see. Come on in. Senator John Kennedy, Republican from Louisiana. At the lunch today, sir, my bet is that the president will say, cut taxes or else. And maybe that's what I want to say to him. What about you? You're going to be at the lunch?
I will. Here's what I hope. Here's what I hope the president says, Stuart. I hope he says, let's vote. I believe very strongly that within the next week, I'm ready to go this afternoon. we need to have a vote on repeal and replace in 2 years. Now, I'm prepared to vote on something to replace now. And the way Senator McConnell was going to do this was going to put the bill on the floor and let everybody offer amendments. Democrats, Republicans, independents would stay there as long as we needed to stay, where everybody got to have their say. Some of my colleagues don't want to even vote to proceed, to allow us to debate, which I don't understand.
Well, we understand there will be a vote on Monday of next week.
I hope so. I hope so. It's time. Look, but I think it's clear, Stuart, that some people who heretofore said that they opposed Obamacare now like it. And this is America. You can believe what you want. But if there are Republicans who now like Obamacare, they need to stand up and say it, and own it. And the only way to do that is to have a vote.
Don't you want to hear a presidential push big time for tax cuts?
Sure.
If you
sure.
don't, I mean, you're toast. Republicans are toast if they don't get tax cuts done.
I'm ready to have this vote. I'm going to vote to proceed, and then I'm going to vote to repeal. And I'm ready to have this vote. I hope we repeal and say we'll replace it within 2 years, and then we move immediately to tax reform. 1.4% growth in GDP is an embarrassment. That's what we have now. Everybody up here ought to hide his head in a bag. It's embarrassing.
Well, you've got a divided Republican Party. You're divided on health care reform. You're divided on tax cuts. I mean, you're up against the wall here. Your reputation as a party which can govern is at stake right here, right now.
Well, we're still better than the Democrats, okay? We're having troubles. There's no question about that. But what we need is a vote now for 6 months, really for 6 years, before I was here. Everybody's talked and offered this idea, and I get it. Everybody has their ideas, and everybody's smart, and everybody sees problems here and good parts there. It's time to vote.
Yes,
let's just stand up and be counted in front of God and country. You either like Obamacare or you don't. If you suddenly like it, then say it. Own it and go back home and explain it to your constituents.
Well said. You see, again, that's why you're a favorite guest on this program. You say it and you tell it how it is. Mr. John Kennedy, Senator, Louisiana, thanks for joining us, sir. Appreciate
it. Thanks, Stuart.
Yes, sir. All right.